Hello my dear students, hope all of you are fine and enjoying your vacation. Keep watching the video and make the topics clear that we are going to discuss here. Today we will start the topic of optical instruments. As we all know, one of the major optical instrument is our human eye. Many other optical instruments are there, such as camera lenses, microscope, telescopes, etc. But in this chapter or in this topic, we are going to discuss the formation of images and their magnification by optical instruments such as microscopes and telescopes. So here we are going to discuss about microscope and telescope. These microscope and telescopes are the two optical instruments which help human eyes in observing highly magnified images of tiny objects and observing very far off objects. That is, microscope is used for observing magnified images of tiny objects and telescope is used for observing very far off or very distant objects. So we are going to first discuss about the topic, which is microscope. So let's give an introduction to microscope. As we already told, microscope is a device which is used to see the image of tiny objects. It is an optical instrument used to see the highly magnified images of tiny and near objects. Here microscopes are considered to be two types, simple microscope and compound microscope. We can classify microscopes into two types, which are simple microscope and compound microscope. So as we already know, microscope is a device used to view the highly magnified images of tiny objects. And one more important optical instrument is telescope. It is an optical instrument used to see distant or far off objects clearly and apparently magnified. Here we are going to discuss about microscope and we will later discuss about the topic telescope. So let's go to the microscope. So the property of a microscope is magnification. An important property of a microscope is magnification. That is, from microscope we are getting magnified images of tiny or very small objects. A good microscope should magnify more. So we should remember that a good microscope should magnify more. So we have to find out the magnification and the formulas for simple microscope. Before entering into simple or compound microscope, we have to remember a few terms, which are the least distant or distinct division and magnification. So we have to know about what is least distant or distinct division and also about magnification for the microscope. So we have to discuss about what is least distant or distinct division. As we already study in our 10th standard, the value for least distance of distinct division for normal eye is 25 cm. The other name of least distance of distinct division is, it is called a near point. So we have to consider what is least distance of distinct division. For that, let us suppose there is a book in front of you and you are comfortable to read whatever it is written on the book. After some time, if you bring the book very close to your eyes, then you cannot read it properly because you will not see it clearly. This is because there should be a minimum distance between our eye and the book. That distance we call it as least distance or distinct division. So if you place the book closer than this least distance or distinct division, then you cannot read the book properly. You cannot see whatever it is written on the book. So there should be a minimum distance between the eye and the object. That minimum distance we call it as least distance or distinct division. So least distance or distinct division is the minimum distance where the object can be seen properly. The standard value for least distance of distinct division is 25 cm and it is also termed as near point. And this value may increases with age of human being. So we should remember that least distance of distinct division is the minimum distance between our eye and the object, and the object should be placed at the least distance of distinct division. If the object is placed below this least distance or distinct division, we cannot see that object clearly. Okay, so that is about least distance of distance division, and for normal human eye its value will be 25 cm. So next we have to discuss about what is magnification. So as we already studied that magnification of a lens is the size of the image to the size of the object, and we already studied the formulas m is equal to the letter for magnification is m, small letter m, and m is equal to hi by ho, that is equal to v by u. So magnification can be taken as the ratio of size of the image to the size of the object. So there should be two types of magnifications. The one is called the linear magnification and the second one is called angular magnification. So magnification can be two types, linear magnification and angular magnification. Here there is a figure. We can see that in that figure AB is considered to be the object and A dash B dash is considered to be the image. Then the ratio of size of the object size of the image to the size of the object is taken to be the magnification. So here we can take the formula M is equal to size of the image is A dash B dash and size of the object is AB. So we can write the formula M is equal to A dash B dash by AB. So this formula gives linear magnification. So linear magnification is the ratio of size of the image to the size of the object. Next we have to consider what is angular magnification. Here we are considering linear magnification because in that figure we can see that both the object and image are in the same line, are in a line. So we are considering here linear magnification. Here we are considering another object AB and we are observing it from here and makes an eye and it makes an angle alpha on our eye. That is, it substends an angle alpha on our eye. If this angle alpha is large, the object is also large. So here alpha is an angle, it is an angle substended by the object on our eye. Angle substended by the object on our eye as shown in the figure. If the value of alpha is large, then we can assume that the size of the object is also large. If value of alpha is small, that is the size of the object is also small. That means the angle alpha gives the measurement of size of the object. So the angle alpha gives the measurement of size of the object. There is also another angle which can be taken as beta, which gives the measurement of size of the image. So the size of the image is given by the angle beta and size of the object is given by the angle alpha. From this, the ratio of these two angles, we will get angular magnification. So we can take angular magnification. It is a ratio of angle substended by the image on the eye divided by angle substended by the object on the eye. So angular magnification is the ratio of angle subtended by the image on the eye divided by angle subtended by the object on the eye. That is, angular magnification M is equal to angle subtended by the image on the eye, that is beta, divided by angle subtended by the image on the object, that is alpha. So M equals beta by alpha. So in the case of angular magnification, M is equal to beta by alpha. So for comparing these two angles, that is the alpha and beta, it is very necessary that both image and object should be at same place. That means both are at the same location. So while comparing these two objects, we should take both image and object at the same place or same location. For making the position of object and image at one place or one location, we can do that. The position of object is changed to image position. That is, as shown in the figure, let's check the figure given here. In that figure, we can see that the position of object and image are at the same location. Now, we can take the angle subtended by the image as beta and angle subtended by the object as alpha. So here we are getting two angles, that is beta and alpha. The ratio of these two angles will give the magnification. So we can take magnification M is equal to beta by alpha. Beta by alpha. So angular magnification can be calculated by using the formula M is equal to beta by alpha. So by using the formulas, these three formulas, that is magnification. M equals size of the image by size of the object, or M equals V by U, or angular magnification M equals beta by alpha. We can enter into the topic microscope and find out the magnification for simple microscope. As we all know that a simple microscope, it is so called because it has only one lens, one convex lens. A simple microscope is a simple convex lens. The another name of simple microscope is, it has another name, and the another name of simple microscope is a magnifying glass. So here we are discussing about simple microscope. It is a convex lens, and we are getting highly magnified image of the object. So simple microscope is also called a magnifying glass. A simple microscope works only when object is placed between focus and optic center of the lens. As we all remember that it is one of the cases of image formation by lenses, convex lenses, as we study in the 10th standard. Please go and check it. So a simple microscope works only when object is placed between focus and optic center of the lens, as shown in the diagram. In that diagram, AB is the object placed between the focus and optic center, and A dash B dash is the image formed. The observer can see the image as highly magnified. So let's check what are the characteristics of image formed. So from that figure, it is clear that the image formed is on the same side of the object. So image formed is on the same side of the object, and the image formed is virtual, erect and magnified. The two properties or characteristics of image formed in these cases are, image formed on the same side of the object, and the image formed is virtual, erect and magnified. So by observing, or for an observer, it is clear that the image formed is magnified. That is, we are getting a highly magnified image. Now we have to calculate the magnifying power or magnification. So to find out magnification, we have to adjust the position of object and image. As we always studied that we have to adjust the position of image and object. That means the position of object and image should be at the same place or same location. Then only we are getting angular magnification. So remember that, what is angular magnification? It is the ratio of angle subtended by an image to the angle subtended by an object when image is situated at least distance of distinct vision. So we should consider that the image should be at a distance which will be equal to least distance of distinct vision. Thus we know that the value of least distance of distinct vision is 25 cm. So we have to get an image at a distance of about 25 cm. So now we are going to calculate the angular magnification. As we told earlier, to find out the angular magnification, we have to make the positions of object and image at one place or one location. For that, we have to redraw the diagram. So please check the diagram given here. So we have given another diagram. When we go through that diagram, we can see that now the position of image and object are at the same place. Now the new position of object is taken as A double dash B double dash. The new position of the object to be taken as A double dash B double dash, and the position of image is also the same, A dash and A dash B dash. So now the new position of object is A double dash B dash, and the position of image is A dash B dash. So as per definition, we know that angular magnification M is equal to beta by alpha. Since beta nearly equal to tan beta and alpha nearly equal to tan alpha for small angles, that we already studied that beta nearly equal to tan beta and alpha nearly equal to tan alpha. This we are taking for making the calculations easier. We can make the calculation more easier while we are taking this conclusion. So we can write the magnification as M is equal to tan beta divided by tan alpha. So we have to find out tan alpha and tan beta from the ray diagram given above. So for that, taking a triangle A dash B dash O, from there we are getting tan beta is equal to A dash B dash by O B dash. And here OB dash, from the diagram itself we can understand that OB dash is equal to capital D, where D is called the least distance of distinct division, that is its value is 25 cm. Then take another triangle A double dash B double dash O. Then from there we are getting tan alpha equal A double dash B double dash by OB double dash. Then from here getting OB double dash also equal to capital D, then tan alpha equal A double dash B double dash by capital D. Then this will be substituting into the equation for magnification M. Then we are getting M is equal to A dash B dash by A double dash B double dash, because the term D will cancel out. So now the equation for magnification is M is equal to A dash B dash by A double dash B double dash. Now we have to find out an equation for this term A dash B dash by A double dash B double dash. For that, let us consider one more diagram. So take one more diagram without the lens. So now we are drawing a diagram without the lens. We have only two triangles here. From the figure it is clear that A double dash B double dash will be equal to AB, because both are the positions of object. So from the figure it is clear that A double dash B double dash is equal to AB. So we have to consider the two triangles and compare them. And this we can take the similar triangles comparison. So for that, take the large triangle A dash B dash O. From there we are getting the value of beta, and take the small triangle A double dash B double dash O, that will be equal to ABO. So here we are taking two triangles, one is A dash B dash O, another one is the small triangle ABO. So comparing these two triangles A dash B dash O and ABO, then we are getting A dash B dash by B dash O equals AB by BO. We have to compare the similar sides. Then we are getting the formula A dash B dash by AB equals B dash O by BO. And we know that B dash O equal to capital D and BO equal to U. So substituting this in the equation for magnification M, then we get M is equal to D by U. M is equal to D by U. So we are getting the formula is M is equal to D by U. Now we have to consider the lens formula. The lens formula is 1 by F equals 1 by V minus 1 by U, where F is the focal length of the given lens, V is the image distance, and U is taken to be the object distance. By applying sign convention, we know that those are in the left side of the lens are taken to be negative. So V should be negative, that is V is equal to minus D and U is also equal to minus U. By putting the sign conventions, we are getting the formula as 1 by F equals minus 1 by D plus 1 by U. From there, we can find out 1 by U. 1 by U equal 1 by F plus 1 by D. Then we can multiply throughout by the term D. Remember that D is the least distance of distinct division. Then we are getting the formula D by U equals D by F plus 1. Then we already known that D by U equal to magnification M. So we can put M instead of D by U. So M is equal to 1 plus D by F. So we are getting an equation for magnification produced by simple microscope as M is equal to 1 plus D by F, where D is called the least distance or distinct division. That is a constant value, that is it should be 25 cm. And if we know the value of focal length of the given lens, we can find out the magnification of a simple microscope by using the formula M is equal to 1 plus D by F. So students, this is about the derivation of magnification produced by simple microscope. So remember that here we are taking angular magnification, and the formula for angular magnification is M is equal to beta by alpha. By using it, we are getting the final formula for magnification as M is equal to 1 plus D by F. So students, hope all of you can understood the topic, and stay watching with the video and make the topics clear. Thank you.